Who should I be listening to?
Weird entity A or B?
Or neither. Let's just stay the course for now. The Bureau's in danger. We know we need to repair the thing. The astral plane won't break reality on my watch. That's the cave sand. Looks like the astral blade goes both ways. In the astral plane.
Andrew Day plus 86. Working at Chile.
There's the etching. They sure changed their tune all of a sudden. I'm overthinking this whole board former thing. They can sort out their own business so long as it doesn't get in my way. Obsessing over these problems is something Trench would do, but I've got my intuition. And you?
The nail is almost repaired. You really do have a knack for this kind of work. Any progress with the nail? Of course. I've been busy with surface analysis. Its composition is remarkably similar to that of material found in the astral plane, but it alters itself between my observations. It's almost as if it doesn't like being examined.
So the nail is from the astral plane?
Not necessarily. See, if we assume that, we're suddenly facing a lot of new questions. How did something so large get out of the astral plane? How did it get inside the oldest house? Did a threshold bring it in? Did people? Maybe through the motel.
Maybe it was always here.
Doubtful.
Have you spent any time looking into the crystals growing around here?
As if I could resist. The biggest question is where it comes from. A threshold? Or is it native to the Foundation? But if so, why doesn't it grow in the rest of the oldest house? The fact that they returned to an earlier state when damaged is severely inconsistent with our reality's adherence to linear time. So either they're A, partially conscious, or B, organic elements that are foreign to and yet influenced by our dimension. The jury's still out. Have you learned anything about the crystals?
I have a power that lets me stretch them.
Huh.
Yep. Any idea what Marshall would be doing down here?
That information is on a need-to-know basis, Faden. Sorry, I can resist. But honestly, I never had much interaction with Marshall. She only came to me when she was looking for Darling. But this is Helen Marshall we're talking about, the woman who single-handedly dealt with the Bergen Peak AWE. If she's down here, it's because she needs to be.
Well, clearly she couldn't handle this one on her own.
I'll see you later, Emily. Good luck. Take notes.
Don't be a stranger.